What is up, Dingle's Crypto? Very exciting video for you today. We're going to talk about my top five DeFi protocols for 2021. And these are all great protocols. I mean, there's no specific one that I want to pick out. But we have the black hole of DeFi, just sucking in all the protocols into one dashboard. I'm sure you probably could guess which one that is. The old but new. New blockchains are coming out, and new smart contract blockchains, Polkadot specifically, and we're going to look in depth on that. The Fed. I mean, DeFi has a Federal Reserve as well, and we'll talk about that. The one-way bridges. Bridges between blockchains are huge, but most of them will turn into one-way bridges, and it mostly will go towards the one ecosystem with the most development and adoption, right? So keep that in mind. And the most interesting at the end, I have the most interesting DeFi protocol at the end. They actually just partnered today, and it's looking very interesting. Very interesting stuff happening with that. I'm kind of interested in to see what will happen in the future. So let's just jump right into it. We're going to be discussing Yearn Finance for the black hole of DeFi, because it's definitely looking like they are creating an interface that uses a bunch of different DeFi protocols and their tools associated with specific protocols. So we got Cover Insurance, Acropolis DeFi tools, Cream lending and borrowing, and yield farming, Sushi's swap, and Pickle's yield farming tools. Right, so, and then they also just partnered with Alpha Finance, which is a vault, and they have a very cool leverage vault, high yield strategy. So, very cool stuff happening with Yearn. I think it will continue to, their V2 is coming out too soon, which is exciting. And a lot of exciting things are happening with Yearn and their collaborations with all these other DeFi tokens. So keep an eye on Yearn Finance. Definitely could go 100,000 plus this year. That will be very nice to see. Now the old but new. And when I say that, is simply DeFi on Polkadot. Akala is one of the main protocols that are hopefully will get a parachain on their roadmap, which one thing that does kind of sketch me out is they haven't updated the 2024 Q4 checkmark. Like, that was like a month ago, guys. What are you doing? Yeah, that's kind of sketch. I don't like that. Like, just little thing that like that can put you off. Just but that's not to say that DeFi on Polkadot will be huge. Synthetics with Laminar, synthetic assets. It's just you gotta be careful, because see, they updated their timeline and the roadmap, so that's nice to see. And then there's a lot of other DeFi protocols on Polkadot. So we got Akala, Staffy, Bifrost, Equilibrium, Centrifuge. I love Centrifuge. Zenlink, Hydra DX, Laminar, Mangata. I haven't looked through all these. And then application layer, we got PokeSwap, SushiSwap, and Clover. So keep an eye on all these. These are very, very interesting. And if they don't get a parachain, look for them building on top of something like Edgeware, which is Polkadot's parachain smart contract blockchain, right? So very interesting stuff happening throughout DeFi on different blockchains, and Polkadot specifically. So let's go into the Fed of DeFi, and that is MakerDAO. MakerDAO is essential and fundamental for DeFi, because their DAI, these decentralized stable coins, are the main Lego pieces for the entire DeFi ecosystem. DAI has been used for a lot of DeFi tools and integrating for DeFi products, right? So DAI is one of the key ecosystem products, right? So Maker, once again, might have a good year in price, but that's not the point. I'm just saying that it's just an essential for the success of DeFi, and DAI is. So, and they also have Maker burn, so they are burning Maker 1% of the supply every year. So after 10 years, that's 10 to 15% of the total supply will be burnt. So it's a long-term hold, guys. I'm only in it for the long term. I like Maker a lot. Now let's go to these one-way bridges, because they have been bumping this year. They've been popping, locking and dropping So Wrapped Bitcoin is a centralized option, but they already have 110,000 Bitcoin wrapped and put onto the Ethereum blockchain. And 110,000 Bitcoin, guys. And those aren't going back unless something happens to the Ethereum blockchain, right? Those aren't going back. They are earning passive income or using, they are getting utilized on the Ethereum blockchain, providing liquidity, using it as collateral, X, Y, and Z, yield farming, blah, 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 blah. A lot of things are happening with Wrapped Bitcoin on the blockchain. Next is the Ren Bridge. They have a Bitcoin bridge to Ethereum, and it's popping. Currently, there's 12,785 Bitcoin on the using the Ren VM and the Ren bridge to the Ethereum network. $440 million worth of Bitcoin they secure through their bridge, right? So these are one-way bridges, and I don't see those Bitcoins ever going to go back to the Bitcoin blockchain and be utilized on the Bitcoin's blockchain, because there's nothing to do there. There's not. It's just a lonely island over there, and you don't want to be on that. So I want to see these two continue to grow, and I think they will, especially with the increase in DeFi products. And RenVM has a lot of a different. I mean, I would not be surprised if we will see Bitcoin on the Polkadot blockchain here shortly. We'll see what happens exactly. It's exciting. 2021 will be a very, very exciting year. I'm super pumped. Last but not least is my most interesting. Actually, they just did a collab today. It's a very weird partnership, but I needed to bring them up today for one specific reason, and that is Furlcomb dropped their token, right? So it's called LBP, and you can go ahead and swap and get your combo tokens through Balancer. And then I don't know exactly what they're doing with their token. I haven't read much into it, but they only have a 48-hour window where they have liquidity in that pool. So keep that in mind. It has like 24 hours left to go. But one thing I do want to point out, and why I say they're the most interesting, if you don't know what they do, they basically help you build smart contracts easily by just putting building blocks. So you can build a smart contract very easily and just do random stuff. And what they just partnered with today is Gelato, which is like a bot service, helps you build an Ethereum automation protocol. So they are partnering to make like an automation smart contract trading algorithm strategy. So if you're into those things, check this out. I'm sure it's going to be very interesting. And Furlcomb just dropped a token. Gelato might, who knows what's going to happen, but it's super interesting. Soon you will be able to create your own automated DeFi strategies with Furlcomb's awesome drag and drop interface. Awesome stuff, guys. So customized bots, you'll be able to use and create your own DeFi strategies using these two platforms by dragging and dropping. In the future, it's not out right now, give them a couple months, 6 months maybe. But that's very interesting, very exciting stuff. That is my most interesting DeFi protocol coming out shortly. And that is all I have for you today. Please, if you enjoyed this content and if it added value to your day, please leave a like and subscribe. We're almost to 1,000 subscribers. Awesome, awesome, awesome stuff. And if you want to keep up with the latest, shoot me a follow on my Twitter, joshhudson.eth. Link is in bio. And then lastly, if you want to chit-chat, there's the Discord server also in my bio, as well as my Telegram. All right, peace out till next time. Dingle, dingle.